Stevie Eskinazi hit his second first-class 100 to give Middlesex the edge against Yorkshire after day three, despite 5-89 from Jack Brooks. Middlesex picked up on 130-2, and Eskinazi and Bailey both built on their starts, extending their third wicket stand to 121, Bailey producing some brutal straight drives off Patterson early in the day. Eskinazi was looking fluent too, though this flashing cut only just evaded the man at point. Rafiq was making his second debut in the four-day format for Yorkshire since re-signing recently, but remained wicketless as he was hit for a maximum by Bailey. The Australian international also took a liking to Brooks, striking him for multiple boundaries. Yorkshire had some respite 20 minutes before lunch when Rhodes dismissed Bailey, Brezhnev with the catch at point. Simpson was the new man in and looked in good nick, finding the boundary twice before lunch, which Middlesex reached on 232-3. In the afternoon, Eskenazi and Simpson took their partnership to 41 before Simpson went for 15, Brooks the bowler, Brezhnev with another catch. Eskenazi continued to progress alongside new man Franklin, raising the prospect of Middlesex building a significant first innings lead. After Eskenazi's maiden ton for Middlesex, opener Gubbins joked that he'd seen little of the 22-year-old due to a new partner off the field, and Eskenazi's new girlfriend is clearly having an excellent effect on his batting as he brought up a second ton in just four first-class innings. The visitors took tea on 318-4, Eskenazi and Franklin on 112 and 29 respectively. Following the break, the fifth wicket partnership continued to grow, Franklin reaching his 50 with over half his runs in boundaries. Eskenazi made his 150 and Middlesex passed Yorkshire's first innings total of 406. Eskenazi finally fell for 157 to Brooks, Williamson with the catch, the partnership with Franklin worth 172. Brooks often takes wickets in bursts, and so it proved here, the seamers next over seeing off Sterling for 5, a third catch of the innings for Brezhnev. The very next over saw Williamson's spin claim fellow twirler Rayner for a free ball duck, Lee's the catcher. Brooks completed his 5-for by dismissing Franklin for 99, agonisingly short of his ton, Middlesex losing 4 wickets for just 26 runs. Roland Jones and Murtagh put on an unbroken stand of 12 to take Middlesex to stumps, Roland Jones unbeaten on 14, Murtagh 7 not out at the other end. Middlesex 470-8 at close, a handy first innings lead of 64 with 2 first innings wickets still remaining, raising the possibility that they just might be able to put the defending champions under some pressure on the final day.